Okay, so today we're gonna do something a little bit different. We're building a bed. Okay. No, we're not gonna do that episode today. But don't worry, it's still the same topic. I'm talking about my reflections on the vlog. It's funny because I started the vlog and I thought, oh yeah, my life is gonna be crazy and there's gonna be a couple of things I'm gonna have to work on. I'm gonna have to work on, you know, being comfortable in front of the camera, making engaging content, and being consistent. And so, you know, I was focused on those three things and yeah, like I saw the need for them and whatnot. But then there's these other things that you learn in this like crazy world of vlogging. And I've been vlogging for, I'll call it 2 months. I know this is episode 6, but I did start a little bit before I started putting out the episodes. And I just wanted to share some of the experiences that I've been having. And so the first one is making a plan, but being flexible. You know, if you guys saw the last one, we were going to do a sunset shoot.
We were going to head out for a sunset shoot, but we didn't make it, you know. Somebody wanted a roti and...
It wasn't a sunset today, okay?
That is true. It was pretty overcast, so the sunset would have been pretty crappy. So,
you know, like, that's not, like, uncommon for anybody who wants to do a sunset shoot if you're late or you miscalculate the time. But this happens, like, all the time when I do a vlog. So that episode where I was building the bed with the guys, that actually, like, went awry because then while we were building it, one of my daughters injured her leg and then she had to go to the walking clinic, and then one of the guys, he had to go kind of last minute. So I was just like, okay, I can't be like messing around with the camera anymore. Like, I have to like actually help put the bed together. Surprise, right? You know, and then I had another thing I was gonna film this week where I was gonna go pick up somebody from the airport and they were coming in the afternoon, and then her flight got delayed constantly to the point where it got delayed so bad that she ended up arriving at 2 a.m. almost 12 hours later than when she was supposed to arrive, and that I was going to go downtown and film some b-roll and get some planes and talk about this topic, and then it just didn't happen. And then 2 a.m. is too dark, I'm not going to shoot anything. So just kind of have to be flexible. The behind the scenes and the ride-alongs, I realize, are like the most fun for me. And I feel like you guys enjoy them the most, and so, but those are like really hard because I have to ask for help, because I'm the one behind the camera and directing stuff, and so to have the other body to shoot and stuff, like it's just so much easier to have a person than to walk around with more gear and set up a tripod, and it's humbling because asking for help is not easy, especially when you have to do it often. Especially when you're trying to create stuff, and you know, you can't always like be like, here's some money, like come help me. And one thing I'm learning is not, and it's not new, is to be intentional with my time. I don't want to be in the office for every episode, and so I want to, you know, be able to go places and obviously take you guys along. And so it's, you know, thinking about episodes that I can do or themes that come up with this specific thing that I'm doing, and it's forcing me to be so much more intentional with my time, but also like think about you know, what I want to do with this you know, episode or this experience that I'm going through. And it's funny because it kind of connects to the making plans things and being intentional, because then you can make a plan for something and then it totally goes awry. But yeah, like I'm so much more selective with my time now and things, and we all have our time wasters and we're not perfect, but yeah, it forces you to really evaluate what you're doing with your time when you become so much more busy on top of being so busy already. So no matter what project you're working on or what skill or talent you're trying to develop, I feel like these three things are so important, especially if you want to start something, if you want to venture into something and, you know, work on something, try something new, you know, just making a plan, and but also being flexible, because as a noob, you don't always anticipate all the things, and then just it's just life, right? Life happens and you don't anticipate everything. Asking for help, clear obvious factor of, yeah, I don't know everything, but there's people who can help me, who are better. But also there are people with complementary skills that can help me grow in this. And, you know, having, you know, guys like Tristan and Andrea and Aldrin to help me put these things together have been so good. And then, of course, you know, the other people who have been in front of the camera for different things, it's been amazing to have that help. And finally, just being intentional with your time, because before you know it, you know, another week has gone by and I'm like, oh, like, what have I done? So guys, if you're working on a new project or you're trying to, you know, develop a skill, I think these three tips will be useful to you. On top of that, I'm just learning from this whole vlogging experience to just be patient and let the chips fall where they fall. So I'm having a more philosophical episode this week, as you can tell. But thank you guys so much for tuning in. Thank you for all those who have been giving me feedback and letting me know what you think. That's really helpful and I really appreciate it. Thank you for those who have subscribed on, you know, the YouTube and the Facebook, and you know, who've tuned in on the Instagram. But yeah, if you like this video, as you know, give me a like. And if you love it and you want to see more of this, subscribe. But for now, we are going to just cut it right here. I have a wedding to go to tomorrow. So, you know, follow me on IG stories for updates on that. I usually do a large number of Instagram stories on shoot days. So tag along with me there. And I will see you guys next time. Peace. Who've subscribed and, you know, joined the realm of the conquerors.